Hey, welcome to a new video. Today is all about psychedelic video and images. Do you want to know how you can create such kind of footage? In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can recreate this with just water and soap, or is it washing up liquid? I don't know. Basically, it's very simple when you know which lighting source is the best for you. I'm going to share my settings as always. Let's do it. You really don't need a lot of equipment to take footage like this. Of course, you need a camera and a macro lens or any kind of macro adapter like extension tubes or the Raynox 250. And you need a tripod, and that's the most important item, a large bright diffuse light like that softbox for example, and some dishwashing liquid and a straw. Oh yeah, and a glass. As a first test, I used that step up adapter ring, but of course a glass would work as well. Here I'm filming the flat surface of the soap water on that adapter ring. One of the advantages using such kind of ring or glass is that the surface is pretty stable and you have 1 or 2 minutes to take images. In the next few minutes I will show you the results you can get using different light sources and different setups. But the most important light source we have is the diffused box, because we will work with the reflection of that white plain area. To understand what I'm actually talking about, let's take a closer look on this video. Although there are crazy different lights everywhere, you cannot see them because the bubble is transparent. That's why we need the diffused box. The reflections will reveal and brighten up the psychedelic colors. On the surface of such a bubble, there's a lot of action going on. Basically, it's like a thunderstorm. Look! I think now it's even more clear why we need that diffuse light. Where the reflection is, the color really pops and the rest is completely invisible. So the bigger the diffuse light, the better. Look at the display, that's pretty cool. Okay, before I give you some more tips, let's take a closer look at the footage I took. I've spent a lot of nights the last weeks creating and watching this kind of stuff, and it really somehow calms me down. There's really not much you have to do, because the color and the lighting and the movement is changing all the time. Every time you discover new colors and new shapes, and it actually never gets boring. But there's one big problem. Because we need the reflection of the diffuse light, we have to tilt the camera a little bit. Because we're doing macro and we have a very short focusing distance, we get a very small field of depth. If we want a sharp image from edge to edge, we have to close the aperture. I was filming at f11 with the APS-C camera, Sony A6300, but even at this aperture the corners were not sharp. And what's the solution here? Use the strongest light possible, or crop the corners a little bit afterwards. Because I wanted to brighten up everything a little bit, I had to reduce the noise a little bit afterwards in Lightroom, which is illustrated by this green line here. I just added the settings for you. To get rid of that noise issue, I chose really slow shutter speeds, which helped a little bit. What do you think? I think it's so hypnotizing. When you take images like this and you think, hey, it's always the same, just change the amount of soap. This is one of my favorite. Okay, those flat soapy surfaces were pretty cool, but now I will show you what kind of images and videos you can take using real bubbles, real round bubbles. I will show you how you get from this to this. Great colors, but I'm still fighting a little bit with that light. We're at ISO 800, which is okay, but I wish my light was a little bit stronger. Yeah, I created those bottles with a straw, which was pretty easy, but just don't use too much dishwashing liquid. And now I don't just want to use the reflections of the diffuser, I want to create a different image. And therefore I need as much light as possible, so I turned on all lights I had. And especially using that small torch created an amazing effect which I did not expect. It looks as if sparkling crystals are dancing around the surface. Let's do some more. Again, the colors on the reflections are popping even more. I try to add more contrast and color by using more light source. That just made it even worse. But that's not the image I'm looking for right now. Let's take a closer look on the top of that bubble. After about 20 seconds, the top becomes really colorful. And then I almost got a heart attack because my tripod crashed. But well, isn't that beautiful? I mean, incredible. Let's create one more. Would you have expected that a soap bubble looks like this? On a soap bubble, it looks as if there's no gravity. Look at all those small little dots fighting their way up the bubble, and when reaching the top, making the bubble burst. I just did a short ISO check, and I got all my lights turned on ISO 1000. Well, that's the image I can get. Hey, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, YouTube offers the possibility to really show it to me by using this button right here, or is it here, doesn't matter. If you have any questions, just leave a comment below. As always, I will answer every comment. At the moment, I'm working on a second video about soap and water bubble photography, which is only about photography with a flash, which I did not mention in this video because I really like this video footage, which had to be shown right now. The second part will be uploaded in 2 or 3 weeks, I guess. Have a good day and see you next week.